All right, hello, greetings, traveler. Lovely to have you with me. This is VHS Quest, where I'll go to local charity shops in search for VHS tapes of yesteryear. You know, if you grew up with VHS, there is a magic about it that, you just can't get on a, digital video disc. Or on the Netflix. You know, if I could have my way, I'd start a streaming, service that just had, VHS tapes. It looked like a rental store. You went through the aisles, you clicked on the tape, and then it just automatically started playing the entire VHS, trailers and all. That would be my absolute perfect, Jabberwocky on the webs. Yesterday, I went to a couple charity shops. I got tapes, it was half off day at one place. So I got tapes for 50 cents. And then at the other shop, I got them for 20 cents each. I got a giant crate back here, and we're going to go through it and show you what I got. Right. First tape in the series. I'm not going to go into detail on every tape. Chances are, you probably know what these are. And if you don't, you have Google. So, it's fine. I got a Darkman. Darkman 2. The Return of Durant. He returns to get Darkman. The first one had Liam Neeson. This one does not, I don't think. I think he only did the first movie. But Sam Raimi film, good stuff. Love the Darkman. I got Hocus Pocus. They're making a sequel. I've actually never seen this. Because I don't watch witches, I date them. That's a weird fact. We got Blue Thunder. This is what kicked off, I believe, the high-tech chopper craze of the 80s, like with Airwolf and such. I believe Roy Schneider is in this, or the dude from Jaws. Great tape, very cool. I got this guy. Now, I got this because we're having crazy weather, so I thought this would just be a good precursor to see what's going to happen in future months here. I got Twister. Not the board game, but the air phenomenon. So I look forward to watching this. I saw it in theater, but I just remember something about a cow. I don't know. Who knows? I've got, this is a double. I already have this. I think this is my third copy of it. But I've got Crocodile Dundee. Oh, that ain't a knife. This is a knife. If you've seen the film, you know something. You know something. Who knows? This is one I saw in theaters as a kid. Ice Pirates. This is a great movie with Robert Urich, who was in Vegas, the TV show. Great deal. I think I have these already as well, but these are better copies. I got the bastardized Indiana Jones version for people that wear beige pants. Romancing the Stone and Jewel of the Nile. Both great movies, though. They're fun. But this is literally like, you know, hey, we're going off the Indiana Jones craze, aren't we? I got this one. I'm really excited to have found this. I haven't seen this cover for this film either. But Elvira, Mistress of the Dark. This is a great film. Very funny. I like it a lot. Elvira still looks exactly the same because she's a vampire and doesn't age. So that's fun. Next here, I got one of my favorite films of all time with one of my favorite people, Chris Elliott, Cabin Boy. That was a brilliant, brilliant movie. I love it to death. Great find. Then I got this David Lynch, Dune. Looking forward to the new one coming out on HBO Max on my birthday. That'll be exciting. So very cool. Then I found this guy, The Burbs, with Tom Hanks, Carrie Fisher, Princess Leia, and Corey Feldman, Felddog. Great stuff there. That's a classic. Just a classic. Oh my god, I got so many tapes. It's too many tapes. I found this one, Blood Simple. I was gonna watch this one on my friend's Plex server, but it's all pixelated and I couldn't get past the first 10 minutes. He like uploaded the worst digital scan of the film I've ever seen. So I look forward to watching this on VHS. It's a Coen Bros. Pick. Great movie. Francis McDermott. Or a lot of other people, probably. Who knows? Looks good. Then I got this one. It's the sequel to The Crow. Called City of Angels. Never seen it, but I'll watch it. I know I saw The Crow in the theater. I don't remember. I just know Brendan Lee was killed during the filming of it. And that was a bummer. Huge bummer. He would have gone places. Let me grab some of these out the back here. Next up, we got Heathers. Story, no one with the name Heather. That's a fun one. Great to have. This is my second copy of this one. And I just watched this one for the first time the other day. Blade. Also, a Blade 2 at home. I'm going to give that one a watch. You know, I don't like 90s films. They don't age well, for some reason. I don't know why 80s movies seem to age better than 90s films. Or maybe this was the end of the 90s, early 2000s. I don't know. But it's like just all rave and weirdness. But it's a good movie. I liked it. It's fine. Oh my god, I've got so many tapes. Next up, we got Red Dawn. About a Russian invasion in the Colorado town. Perhaps someday I'll go out to that town. I think it's a real place that they filmed some of this stuff. You know, it's got an all-star cast. Great movie. Lovely to have that, finally. Then I've got Tank Girl, another great film. I think Iggy Pop is in this, if I remember correctly. I haven't seen it since it probably came out. That's weird. It says, I don't know why it says this on the back of the movie. It says, buy four, get one free. Why would you need five copies of this film? I don't know. Who knows? This one really excited me, even though it's ripped. I'm going to repair it. I got Phil Collins, but seriously, The Videos. Let's see if I can match up my face. Is that pretty good? Hello, I'm Phil Collins. Alright, that's a good one. What's on here? Another Day in Paradise, Do You Remember? Not the good stuff. The weird part of his career that I can take it or leave it, but I love it. And it's got this fold-out thing of pics. Great. Lovely to have that. A lot of fun. Loved him in the movie Buster. Great thing there. Alright, let's get here. We got singles. This was a score and a half because I absolutely love this film. Mannequin. Great to have this. This is brilliant. Kim Cattrall. Andrew McCarthy. Part of the Brack Pack. Great. Saw him on like Good Morning America talking about being a part of the Brack Pack, or he read a book or something. Who knows? Next up, we got this weird thing I saw. It's called Pure Lethal, which I guess is new scenes, new angles, and explosive outtakes of Lethal Weapon. It's a very weird tape, and I thought, grab that. That's weird. I have Lethal Weapon. Next up, we got Tom Hanks and John Candy in Volunteers. And this is a video store release box version, which I thought was very cool. And it says, please rewind on the tape. We will do. And this is for the kids at home. Sorry, rated R. Real bummer. Real bummer, buddies. Someday, you'll be able to watch it. Next up, I found this and a sealed copy of The Wrath of Khan. How much was it? $5.99 right there. Not too shab. I only paid, I think I got that, the 20 cent one. Next up after that, we got this one. Not my favorite doctor, but I believe he was the doctor after my favorite doctor, Peter Davidson. Of course, my favorite doctor is Tom Baker, the fourth doctor. I think this is the fifth doctor. But I've seen all of these, but I will watch this because it's on VHS. And look at that lovely cover. They don't do the work anymore, you know? They just slap some digital nonsense on a thing and... Hey, it's Sharknado. Everybody loves Sharknado. I get you a Sharknado. No, don't. Don't do that. That's horrible. This is weird, and this is why I grabbed it. This is a Touchstone preview tape for Sylvester Stallone's Oscar... Hilarious new $22 million comedy hit. Demo tape, not for sale, but it doesn't tell me what the hell the film is. It just says Oscar demo. Well, that should be fun. I don't know what $22 million comedy hit he was in. I think I've seen a lot. Was it Rambo? Was it Rocky? I don't remember him being in a bunch of funny movies. But who knows? Maybe he was. Up next, this was great to find. John Carpenter's Christine. After Stephen King's lovely book. Then after that, we got this one. I saw this one in theaters, and I liked it. It's called Woof. It's a good one. Look. Like our faces almost match up there, don't they? I took too long doing that, but that's kind of creepy. Okay, well that's a good movie. And look, same but different. Weird. Okay, that's a good one. Then I found this, and I thought this was great. Pink Floyd's The Wall. It's a good film. I like the visuals. I like the music. You know, good stuff. It's a good movie. Great to have it on a format that I'll watch. All right, up next, we got one of my favorite movies of the 80s. This is quintessential 80s. And it's got one of the most unexpected endings I've ever seen in a film. But To Live or Die in L.A. Also, Wing Chun did insanely great soundtrack work on this. So, check that out. Such a great stuff. This was a box office flop, if I remember correctly. But it stars the great Gene Wilder and Gilda Radner. Haunted Honeymoon with Dom DeLuise. I think I saw this in theaters as a children. I don't remember. But had to have that. That's a great one. Got a couple left here on VHS Quest. Next up, we got another Stephen King. This one's called Misery. And, you know, hopefully it's not miserable to watch. No, I'm kidding. Of course, I've seen this. This is a good movie. I love it. Good to have you. Welcome to the collection, friend. Then we got this one. I watched this the other day on Tubi TV, and I thought it was weird, but it's from Clive Barker, and I liked it. It was fine. Candyman. Who doesn't like Candyman? Look, my eyes all big. Ah, that's a weird one. All right. So, and then our last tape is I found the prequel to Crow 2 City of Angels. The Crow. It's the prequel to Crow 2. So that's really exciting. And then also I found a Sony VHS. Not VHS. I found a Sony Sports Walkman for $3.50. And, you know, as a children, that was the Cadillac of Walkmans. If you had one of those, you were either from a rich family or your parents loved you. And I didn't have one. So that's fine. I did later have a Sony Walkman, but it wasn't the sports model, which was waterproof or water resistant. I don't think really anything's waterproof. But that is all. It was quite a score of VHS tapes yesterday. It rarely happens anymore locally, but I went to the town that is next to me that I hate, and it turns out they don't know what they have and they don't care. So they are getting rid of their tapes in droves. So it was an unexpected. I saw more tapes yesterday than I'd seen since the 90s. It was incredible. And this isn't even all the ones I should have grabbed. This, but I have so many tapes. It's ridiculous. People buy me tapes. People donate tapes. I got too many tapes. Too many tapes. I live in a child-sized bedroom, and I've got too many tapes. It's the dream that I once had, but I've got too many. So thank you so much for watching VHS Quest. I'm going to go up to the next state over, possibly next week, and go on another quest for tapes and general nonsense from yesteryear. I collect retro technologies. This has been shot on a Sony Sony Hi8 camcorder. So you know, this is the way. But thank you for joining me on Magic Cyclops. This has been VHS Quest. I hope you enjoyed it. Maybe you didn't. Who cares? Either way, I win because I got all the tapes. So, whatever. All right, have a good day. Hopefully we'll find more. We can make more of these. You can watch more of these. We'll catch you on the next one. Good day.